Okay, this is an article from the Bay Citizen News Culture Community. This is government under fire as radiation is found in milk and rain. Everybody's really, really upset that the federal government has still not published any official data on nuclear fallout from the Japan disaster, nor do they probably really intend to. Radiation from Japan rained on Berkeley during recent storms at levels that exceeded drinking water standards by 181 times and has been detected in multiple milk samples by the U.S. government, has still not published any official data. Well, I think it's really interesting that Berkeley, one of our biggest universities in California, is testing water and everything from their university site, but our government keeps telling us that these levels are safe. The EPA on Tuesday said it expected to release results of tests from radioactivity in rain and snow within a day or so. So then on Friday, 3 days after making that pledge, the EPA officials repeated the same statement and said the data would likely be released over the weekend or on Monday. Okay. We have accelerated our precipitation and drinking water sampling and expect to have results in the coming days. Well, coming days, it's a month later. So, the rooftop monitoring program managed by UC Berkeley's Department of Nuclear Engineering detected substantial spikes in rain-borne iodine-131 as it peaked at 20.1 becquerels per liter, a measure of radioactivity on the roof of the Echeverry Hall during heavy rains a week ago. The federal maximum level of iodine-131 allowed in drinking water is 0.111 becquerels per liter. And then they have a graph here of what they found. The levels exceeded federal drinking water thresholds, known as maximum contaminant levels, or MCL, by as much as 181 times. However, the material has a half-life of 8 days, meaning it breaks down quickly and it quickly dissipates in the environment. Drinking water safety standards are based on prolonged exposures. Now, it isn't drinking water, said the MCA, that can be averaged for a period up to a year. But it is striking that rainwater could be measured in Berkeley with radioiodine that is that far above the level you would generally be permitted to drink. The material, which is one of the most toxic radioactive elements, was spewed when nuclear power plants melted down. UC Berkeley researchers also discovered trace levels of iodine-131 and other radioactivity materials believed to have originated from Japan. Low levels of iodine-131 were detected by state officials this week in milk harvested from San Luis Obispo. Now, here's the problem, is that if there is, higher levels of iodine-131, the government has a right to contact all of the, we have a huge industry here for dairy cattle, especially in Southern California. So there would be a need to alert them so that they could take their cattle out of the fields and off of the grass and bring them into shelters and feed them stored grains and things that they have. I mean, that's a pretty simple fix, I would think, other than the water that they would be drinking. So, this this just goes to show you the extent at which the United States government will go to disregard its citizens and what they're actually being exposed to. They flat out are doing whatever they want, and they'll say what they want when they want. And I won't even believe that. I won't believe the EPA. I won't believe anybody. So we have to keep finding all these different places where we can get little hints of what's going on. You know, like this graph. Yeah, it shot up on one day at 20.1 becquerels. That was on the 23rd, 24th. But it consistently stayed up at around 8 to 9, almost to 10, on the 20th through the 25th. And then the levels from the 25th until the 28th, when the data was collected, kind of went back down to still, they're still, don't get me wrong, the zero level is right here. This is the federal maximum level of iodine-131, right here at zero. So anything above that is not going to be healthy. And it doesn't mean that we have to be, you know, we don't have to go into panic mode. Because once you're armed with facts, you can make better decisions, that's all. I don't know, the government isn't even giving us that. So to hell with them, and more research to be done in the public sector. God bless.